So I decided to make an RPG game in 12 hours, and this is how it turned out. This video is sponsored by Sidearm Studios. Sidearm Studios specializes in creating high-quality, production-ready environment art assets on the Unreal Engine marketplace. If you are an Unreal Engine developer who is making a game and needs some realistic assets, you should definitely check them out. So I'll leave some links down in the description if you are interested. So here's the challenge. I want to create an RPG game in 12 hours. But let's be real here, a real RPG game, something like Skyrim, takes a lot of time. So there's no way that a solo developer like myself could make a game like that in just 12 hours. So I did my best to incorporate as many RPG elements as I could, given the limited time limit. So before creating the game, I needed to make a very important choice, and that's the game engine. So this was a pretty obvious choice in my case. I chose Unreal, simply because Unity sucks.
Oh, don't even get me started on the shader graph. I swear, shader graph, it doesn't work. It keeps loading every single second. How are you supposed to do anything?
So I created an empty project. I wanted the game to be in the first person perspective, something like Skyrim. So for that, I created a very simple first person controller. Then I added a sword and a shield. And after some blueprint magic, I had this epic FPS character. I made a character creator menu where players can choose their starting class. So since I had a limited amount of time, my game will have three classes, a knight, a berserker, and a mage. Each class will start with the default weapon. So the knight will have a long sword, the berserker will have an axe with a shield, and the mage will have a staff. Now I wanted to add some dragons in the game. So I found a dragon model on the marketplace and I imported this inside the engine. Then I started working on the animations. And I was very lucky because Unreal has a very sophisticated animation system. So first I made an animation blend space and that holds the idle and the walking animations. These animations are driven by the movement speed. Now it's time to make the AI of the dragon NPC. So I kept things simple because I had a limited time frame. So I made the simple AI that follows the player, and when it reaches the player, when it's close to the player, it will attack the player, and then the cycle will repeat over. I also made a particle system, and I'm not gonna lie, but this looks pretty cool. So at the moment, the dragon has four different attack animations. To damage the player, I simply did some line traces that inflict damage. Lastly, I also made the health bar to show the inflicted damage. So I'm really happy how the dragon turned out. After I finished creating the dragon, I made some skeletons. So these skeleton NPCs will be basic enemies and easy enough for the player to kill. So I started working on the main level of this game, and to create that I used the medieval asset pack. So a huge shout out to Sidearm Studios for sending me this asset pack. I made this knight NPC guy. So for the dialogue, I asked a friend of mine to do some voice acting. I'm making a game in 12 hours and I need your help to play the voice of a fat knight.
Okay.
And this is how it turned out.
Hey you. You see the dragon up there? Go, kill it. Go.
I made an outdoor level as well. So in this outdoor level, I made a basic landscape and I also added some foliage assets in the scene. Now I wanted to add some animals. So I made this deer NPC. So this also turned out really well. I was really happy to see the progress that I had made in such a short time. Now it's time to show you guys some gameplay footage. So if you enjoyed the video, consider subscribing. And if you like the video, please leave a like down below. And that's it. I'll see you in the next video. Enjoy the gameplay.
Hey you, you see the dragon up there? Go, kill it, go.